जय गुरुदेव। डियर स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 11 बॉडी मूवमेंट्स। ओके, सो इन दिस चैप्टर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू द लोकोमोशन इन केस ऑफ एनिमल्स, मींस मूवमेंट इन केस ऑफ एनिमल्स। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मूवमेंट ऑफ वेरियस एनिमल्स। Like first we studied about the invertebrates, means those animals in which backbone is absent, and afterward now we are studying about the vertebrates, means those animals in which backbone is present. Okay, so under this category I have explained you previously movement in case of cockroaches, then movement in case of snails. These two animals are coming under invertebrates, and after that movement in earthworm, this is also invertebrate, and after this movement in birds. So here we started about the movement in case of vertebrates. Okay, in the last class I explained you about the movement of birds, then how birds can fly, how birds can move from one place to another, they can walk also and they can perch also. Okay, means along with flying with the help of wings, they can walk with the help of claws, and perch means hold the branches of plants with the help of their claws. Okay, so these children we have studied in the last class. Now second animal which is coming under the category of vertebrates, that are snakes. So children, movement in snakes, you know that snakes show different kind of movement as compared to other animals. Okay, so I think everybody must have seen snakes somewhere. So if you have not seen really, then also in some serials, in some movies, many of the times they are showing. So let's read what is the kind of movement in case of snakes. Snakes do not have any limbs, and their backbone runs from head to tail. There are scales present on their body. They move with the help of their ribs. Scales and muscles by crawling. So children, here up to crawling we have studied so many things here that which help snakes to move. First of all, they explained here that snakes do not have any kind of limbs. Children, what are the limbs? You should know that limbs are the part of our skeletal system, means our hands and our legs are called human beings limbs. Okay, so in the same way birds also have wings in the form of their limbs and claws in the form of their limbs. So in this way different animals have different kind of limbs, but snakes do not have any kind of limbs. Okay, means haath pair jisko hum bolte hain wo snakes mein nahi hote. So but one another feature is there, that it has backbone. Backbone runs from head to tail, means its backbone is present, means starts from the head and ends up to the tail region. Okay, so in your this book, at the last of this chapter, when chapter is completed, here they have shown the skeleton of snake. You can see here, this is the skeleton of snake. See, this is the backbone, and this backbone is present in its body, which starts from head and it ends up to the tail region. Means this much long backbone is present, and along with the backbone, you can see here, these are the extensions which are the bony parts. These are present along with the backbone, and with the help of these kind of bony structure, they can move because they are movable. Okay, and children, this is the inner skeleton part, means bony part of the snake. They have not shown here muscles and skin. Okay, and you know, in case of snakes, there are scales present on their body, just like fishes. You should know that fishes also have scales on their body. In the same way, snakes also have scales on their body. Okay, and let's see here. Means these kind of designs are made with the help of their scales. If you have new book, you should have a colored picture, and it is more clear, I think. I'm having photocopy of book, so that's why this picture is little bit blur. Okay, so these scales help these snakes to move, because when snakes move, scales which are present on their body, they because they join with the bony part of their skeletal system, which is present inside. Just now I have shown you that scales are in contact with the muscles. So muscles are attached to the bones, and that's why when scales they hold the any surface, or they push, means snakes towards front side. Okay, and with the help of these scales, muscles also move, and with the help of muscles, inner bony part which is present inside and that is ultimately backbone, that also start moving. Okay, so we can say that with the help of scales, muscles, bones, or backbone, they all help the snakes to move. Okay, children, so let's read the next paragraph, what they have given. And these snakes are showing its movement by crawling. Crawling means ring ring ke chalna. Okay, so snakes always show movement which is called crawling movement. And next is, most of the snakes move in a wave like pattern. Children, always you can see that when snakes move, they can't move straight. Okay, they always move in a wavy motion like this. Like whenever we draw any snake, a moving snake, that time also we draw always snake in this way. Okay, means snakes always move in like this way. This is called wavy motion. Okay, so insert a picture of snake, means to give a picture of snake. Here they have given. Here you can see its movement. This is a head of snake, and see how it shows its wavy movement. Okay, and children, this is about the movement in case of snakes. Now movement in case of fish we will study. So birds, snakes and fish, these all are coming under vertebrates, as I have already told you, that because in fish also backbone is present, muscles also present, but main characteristic of vertebrates is to presence of backbone along with the bones. So bony part is present inside the fish also. So let's read movement in fish. Fish have a streamlined body, which means head and tail, and narrow, while the middle portion of the body is broader, that allows them easy movement in water. Okay, so let's first understand what they have written here. Children, in case of birds also, I have explained you that birds also have streamlined body. What is a streamlined body? Here they have written, I have explained you already, that a body shape which is thicker from the middle but thinner from the front and back, means thicker from the middle and tapering from the front and back, that kind of shape is called streamlined shape or streamlined body. So children, in fish you can see clearly that fish has a streamlined body. Okay, and here they have shown from head to tail, if we see, then we can say that it has a streamlined body. And this streamlined body help the animals, those animals which have streamlined body, they get help from this kind of shape in movement. Because in case of birds also, I have explained you that streamlined body help the birds to move in air. Because when they fly in air, there is air pressure, so much air pressure. So with the help of this streamlined body, birds also can move easily by flying. Because this streamlined shape helps to cancel the effect of air pressure. Okay, or we can say reduce the air current. In the same way here, you know, fish are the aquatic animals and fish always live in water. Okay, and in water when they want to move, they can easily move with the help of their streamlined shape, because water also has some kind of pressure, with the that pressure prevent any organism to move smoothly underwater. But with the help of this streamlined body, these animals can cancel or reduce the effect of water current. Okay, water movement. So this is the use of their streamlined body. So to change their direction in water, fish use fins and tail. Fish also use fins for balancing their bodies while swimming. Now insert a picture of a fish. So here picture they have given. Children, what are the fins? You can see this is one fin, and here also this very small fin is given here, which is not easily visible. So here this fin is visible. So these are the fins, okay, and this is the tail. Tail also has two fins here. So children, they have written here that with the help of these fins and this tail, fish can move easily in water. When it wants to change its direction, then this tail helps fish to change the direction. And other fins, they help in the swimming, as well as they help in the balancing, means body balancing. Okay, they make balance of their body in water also. Okay, you can see how fish easily move in water. But if anybody say us to swim in water, those who learn swimming, you can ask them that how it is very tough to swim, means it is a very hard work, or we can put our full energy in swimming. So when we want to swim, then we can put so much of our efforts, and it's a very hard kind of exercise. Okay, so that's why, because water has its pressure and water prevents us to move through it. But because of the streamlined body of fish, and with the help of their fins and tail, they can easily move through the water. Okay, so children, this is all about the fish or movement in case of fish. So here, fish such as sharks do not have any bones, and their skeleton is made up of only cartilage. Children, here let me tell you that what are the cartilages. Cartilages are the kind of soft bones. Okay, means these are not hard bones. These are the kind of soft bones, and these cartilages are also present in our body in many places, inner part of the body also and outer part of our body. You can take example of your ears. Our ears have cartilages, okay, and because of these cartilages we can bend our ears easily. Okay, so these cartilages are soft bones. So here what they have shown, that fish, the variety of fish like sharks, here they have shown, means given as an example, that sharks, they do not have bones in their skeleton, means hard bones are absent in case of these sharks. But cartilages are present, means if cartilages are present in anywhere of any animal, that means they make that animal more flexible. Okay, with the help of cartilages, because these are the soft bones and they can easily bend or move. So cartilage is tough connective tissue which is strong but elastic. Okay, present in the place of bones. So if any organism don't have bones, in case of vertebrates, they have cartilages. Okay, means they must have cartilages if they are coming under the category of vertebrates. So cartilage is a tough connective tissue. Tough means it doesn't mean that cartilage is a soft bone and it can break easily. No, it is a tough structure. It can't move, break easily. Okay, and they are the connective tissues. Our bones also connective tissues. Our blood is also kind of connective tissue. Means connective tissues are those kind of tissues which connect the different parts of our body. So you can see the cartilage also present, which can connect the muscles with the bones. Okay, or we can say they can connect with the muscles to other parts of the body. So that's why they are also connective tissues. They make connection of various parts. Or one thing more they have explained here about the cartilages, that they are strong but they are elastic. Just now I have explained you that children, if you take example of your ears, you can see here that when we want to twist our ear, we can easily twist with the help of our hands. Okay, and even front part of our nose is also made up of elastic connective tissues, which are called cartilages. Okay, and only front part of our nose, means tip of our nose, not at the back of our nose, because that is hard bony part, that is bone. But at the tip of our nose, where holes like nostrils are present, that part is called, that part is made up of cartilage. Okay, so there you can see elasticity, means these cartilages are elastic also, and they are present in some of the parts in place of bones. Okay, means they are the alternative of our bones. Okay children, so this is up to here we have studied about the various kinds of animals. So different animals in case of invertebrates and vertebrates also we have studied here. And children, in the next class we will start about the human beings, means organization of human body, and what kind of organization is there, and how human beings move. You know children, human beings also show different types of movements. We can dance also, we can jump, we can walk with the help of legs. So we can move our other body parts also even. Okay, so children, how these kind of movements are possible in case of humans, that we will study in detail, okay, in the next class. So up to here we have studied about the various animals which are coming under the invertebrates and vertebrates. Okay, so for this class I have explained you about the movement in snakes and movement in case of fish. You read again, and if you find any problem, you can ask me during the doubt session. Okay children, so side by side you must watch the videos, and if you find any problem, you can ask me during the doubt session. Okay, so Jai Gurudev.